Millions of people have plantar fasciitis, heel pain. It's really bad, especially when you get out of bed in the morning. And so I have a book on Amazon about plantar fasciitis, and I kind of want to give away the main content to you here in this video for free, and also an exercise that's very good that is not in the book. It should be in the book, but it's in this video. So anyways, why is the heel pain so much worse when people get out of bed with plantar fasciitis? Okay. Well, the cause of plantar fasciitis, according to many, many reputable sources, is a tight calf muscle, okay? And the calf muscle is in the back of the leg here, and it plantar flexes your foot. So if you pull your foot forward like this, then you'll get a contraction in the calf muscle, okay? So go to Google and type in plantar fasciitis tight calves, and you'll get, you know, you'll get bombarded with articles saying that tight calves cause plantar fasciitis and the heel pain that comes with it. So now, why is the pain worse in the morning when people get out of bed? That's kind of strange. Well, think about it. You lay down, and you know what you can do here? Is if you have plantar fasciitis or you know someone who has plantar fasciitis, have them sit down or lay down with their feet, with their knees extended, and see what their feet do. If their feet are plantar flexed, they want to stay down like this, then that gives you a very valuable clue, because if their feet, they want to stay plantar flexed, then that means the calf muscles are tight and naturally they're pulling the feet forward. It also explains why when you go to sleep at night with the plantar fasciitis, with the tight calves, your feet are like this all night long for 8 hours straight, uninterrupted plantar flexion, uninterrupted tight calf muscles, okay? So you get up in the morning, yeah, your heels are in a lot of pain because your calves have been tight all night. But then you go walk around and you get some of the dorsiflexion, which is the ankle, is the foot being pulled up. It kind of balances out. And so gradually throughout the day, if you go and walk around, then the heel pain will get less. Also, if you're sitting with tight calf muscles, you're going to notice that your feet are going to want to be out in front of you like this. Again, you go and sit for 2-3 hours with your feet plantar flexed, you get up, you're going to feel that heel pain. So the key to getting rid of plantar fasciitis is to restructure your environment so that your feet are not in these long situations of plantar flexion, tight calves, okay? So you do this by doing a few corrective exercises. And a lot of people will fight about, well, which is better, activation versus stretching? With this situation, with sleeping, you know, 8 hours with your feet in plantar flexion, you want to do both. You want to stretch out the calves very well, and you also want to activate the tibia. So this is the muscle that dorsiflexes, pulls the foot up, and so it relaxes the calf muscle actively when you pull up your foot into dorsiflexion here. So you feel a nice strong contraction in the tibia. Calf stretches are a dime a dozen. You know, you go and you stand on a step and you just let your heels drop, or you can put them against the wall here and just stretch the calf, okay? Stretch the calf. After you stretch the calf, then actively activate the tibia, okay? Now here's an exercise that is not in the plantar fasciitis book. I should have put it in there, but it does both at the same time. How cool is that? It stretches the calf and it activates the tibia at the same time. Now how would you do this? You could do this before you go to bed at night even. And that's actually the most important time to do these exercises, is do them before you go to bed and before you get up in the morning. And if you can, do something like wrap your sheet around your feet so that your feet don't dorsiflex. A lot of companies sell these like boots that you put on your feet that keep them from dorsiflexing. You know, that's fine too. So this exercise is you dorsiflex with, in this example, we dorsiflex with the right foot to stretch the calf of the left, okay? So you can see how I'm using my right foot to stretch the calf to dorsiflex the other foot. And now do the other side. So that's pretty cool. You're activating the tibia on the one leg, and then you're stretching the calf on the other. So just use it to pull back on the other foot. The biomechanics, the muscle activation here, the calf and the tibia is very similar to flexing and extending your wrist. Okay, so like, you know, imagine if your wrist is flexed, you know, all night long, you're gonna get carpal tunnel, you're gonna get wrist issues, or like if you type and your wrist is always flexed, you wanna balance it out by extending the wrist. And you know, feel the muscle, it's very similar. The wrists and the ankles are, the way that they move and the biomechanics are actually very, very similar. So balance, that's the key to health and staying out of musculoskeletal pain, is to not allow muscle imbalances to happen. And plantar fasciitis is really bad because you sleep with 8 hours of plantar flexion, and that's why it's really hard to get rid of. You have to really work at it, because if you don't, you're going to go in those situations sleeping for 8 hours, sitting with your feet plantar flexed because the calves are tight, and it just perpetuates itself. So you really have to make an effort to do the opposite, to dorsiflex, to stretch the calves, to control the environment. So when you're sleeping at night, you don't let your feet plantar flex. When you're sitting, you know, put a little prop, you know, whatever, so that your feet stay somewhat dorsiflexed. You want to, plantar flexion and tight calfness is the enemy. So that's what you're really fighting with plantar fasciitis. So I hope you liked this video. It pretty much gave away the entire book, but I really want to give, it's a real problem. Heel pain is a real problem that it affects especially runners and athletes, but also, you know, everyday people. And it's a very difficult muscle imbalance to get a hold of. So I hope that this information gives you an idea of what causes it, and also how to fix it, most importantly. So if you found it helpful, please like it. And the book is on Amazon. It's 28 pages. There's a few things that aren't in this video, but basically the core information is that screen, look for the plantar flexion, and then stretching the calves, activating the tibia, and controlling the environment to get rid of plantar fasciitis for good.